So we got a 2012 Kawasaki Versus, and we also have my roommate taking a shower, so excuse the noise. But here's the issue today, is oil is leaking from the water pump, which is right here. Now I did take off this cover. There's a bolt right here, and a bolt right there, I think. So yeah, it's leaking oil from the weep hole, or the weep slot, which is like right there. You can kind of see it. Anyway, so apparently it's other people that have experienced this. I even had this happen on my R6, although it was leaking coolant instead. So anyway, I'm going to drain the coolant from this, and so this is the drain plug. So I'm gonna try and capture as much of the fluid as I can, not make a mess, pull it apart. And the parts I ordered for it, I just looked up on the Exploded View, and it's the oil seal as well as the mechanical seal. So this is the mechanical seal. I got this. And then this is the oil seal. I just wanted to do both just to make sure. That should be the actual part number. This is not Kawasaki brands. So after we get this off, I believe it's this bolt, this bolt, this bolt, this bolt, and this bolt. Get everything apart. Another thing I had to take off was this cover piece right here. So there's a bolt right there you gotta take off. You gotta undo the one right here. It goes right there. And then you have to undo the one down there. And what I was able to do is just kind of pull back this part right here. That way I don't have to take off all this stuff up here. Just pull it back and it pops out. And the reason I had to do this is this clip, the bolt that I just took out here, I have to take off the radiator cap, which I'll need to do anyway because I got to top off the fluid in here. So anyway, the reservoir is up under there. But yeah, don't forget to fill up your coolant after this as well. Yeah, once you lift up the radiator cap, more coolant starts to come out, so just be ready. Make sure to have a big enough bottle to hold it all. So probably what I'll do is I'll just take off this hose right here, or just take the water pump off and then take off the hose. Either or, then we can get to what's going on inside. Now before you start doing this, I had it level up on a stand to drain all the coolant so most of it can come to this side, but once it's getting real slow like this, I'm gonna go ahead and drop it down from the stand and put it on the kickstand. And the reason being, if the oil is at this level, then you can see that it's gonna leak out of the water pump when I take this out. So you definitely wanna have the bike at an angle, and we'll see if it's gonna start to drip out once we have it at the kickstand angle. I don't think it will. I think the oil should be kind of go to one side of the engine, so we should be fine. Lay the bolts out kind of in the order they were in. Just set that right there. Yeah, just like that. Next, we'll need to pry this off, but first we gotta take off this bolt right here. It's a 10 mil. Gently pull that off. You can see that one of the seals we'll be replacing. Now that we got that off, we can see the oil seal right here. So we'll need to get a flathead and just kind of pop that out. And then we'll have to press out this little metal slot. And then go from there. So I just used a flathead to pop this seal out. You can see it's pretty dirty. Definitely what caused it to fail. And here. Yeah, so I'm cleaning this out real good, and I think I'm gonna go ahead and replace this seal right here. It's really hard to see
can see this thin part right here, but this is like pressed in. On the new one, that's the part that's worth with the blue stuff on it. That's the thing that gets pressed in there, I do believe so. To get that out, probably your best option is to just turn it over, put some stuff around here, and then very gently, it's like put a piece of cloth around here, and then get a socket, set it in there, and gently tap it out with a hammer. And then the same goes for when you're putting it back in. Make sure I clean these, obviously, but yeah, something like that. And then just gently tap it out with a hammer, and then clean all this in here. All right, so eventually came out. Took some serious effort. Yeah, there it is. Got the new one over here. I'll take that out in a second. First of all, I'm going to go through and clean this out really, really good. And if I imagine, I'm going to have to get some really fine grit sandpaper, like 1,000 grit, to get these chunks off inside of here, because you don't want any of that junk staying in here. But yeah, once I clean that up, I'll probably take off this O-ring right here, make sure that's nice and clean. So as I'm cleaning this out, one thing I'll do is this O-ring where this goes around, you can see kind of some stuff on there, so I'm gonna get some soap, some wet sandpaper, about 1,000 grit, and then just lightly go along and smooth it out really, really carefully. I use 500 grit to get this inner stuff out. Most of it's already out. This is still pretty smooth, even though it looks a little dirty, but it's mostly clean. Then I'll go back with 1,000 grit and smooth it out really, really smooth. Because when we put on the new seal, we want everything to be really clean. All right, now here's a new one. I'm a little unsure if this is supposed to stay in there or not. It just came out on the old one. So maybe this is a little bit different design, but yeah, it's basically like that. So this is the new one. What I'm gonna do is put a tiny little bit of grease around this thing when I press it on. The best way to do this is to obviously press it on. I don't really have squeeze it together. I'm gonna put a little bit of grease on here, get it in place, and then use this to really gently tap it down. So, put a dab of grease around here. Like so. And make sure it's pretty good and flush. Put something soft under this. And I clean this out already. I'll do this. Alrighty, got the new one in. Looks pretty good. Got it nice and flush. Make sure everything's flush around it. Make sure it's good and clean. And now I'm gonna put in the new oil seal. It's right here. Wow, that's crazy. Little spring on there. And it's hard to tell. There's all this discoloration and stuff, but I really did a good job about sanding all that really smooth with 1,000 grit sandpaper and cleaned it as best as I can. So it's just kind of stained into the metal, but it's smooth. Yeah, this thing drops in here, like so. Similar to the other one, I'm gonna put just a tiny little bit of grease around this exterior one when I press it in, and on the inside, right there. So just a dab, kind of going around. Make sure your hands are clean when you're doing this. If you had a little piece of sand that gets on here when you're putting it back in, it can screw everything up. So now for the inside, just going around. And this should just kind of squeeze in. Alrighty. next up, I'm gonna clean this little O-ring right here. Make sure this is good and clean. Looks like it's in good shape. You know, if you have all the money in the world, you can replace these, but a lot of times on these newer bikes, as long as they're not damaged and you're careful with them and clean them and just put a dab of grease on them when you put them back in. You use grease with O-rings when you're working with stuff on the engine, you know, so this stuff can get a little oil on that. So the grease kind of acts as a little extra barrier and lubricate it. So just get a dab, kind of put it on like so. And then this, go back around. Again, I clean this. There's still a little bit of residue, but I already smoothed it out. Don't want to damage any of the edges. And then we got the O-ring for that as well. So we'll clean this guy up as well, put that in. Alrighty, before we put this back on, I'm going to, that's right, you guessed it, clean all this really good too. So if there's any stuff you can't really get off, just get some really fine grit sandpaper like before. Also the end of the shaft, you see how that's kind of corroded and dirty? You want to clean that really good as well. Alrighty, so went around and cleaned it up really good. Got some sandpaper because of all this junk back here. And some brake cleaner, got that all really clean. And again, on this shaft, I'm going to put a little bit of grease around there so the seals can not be just touching directly on each other. But yeah, just make sure this is all really clean. Just slap this piece back on. Alright, next up, I'm going to just dry this off real quick. Replace this seal in there with the one that came with it. That's the new one. And then put this on, screw it on, go from there. Alright, got the new seal in, got it nice and clean in there. Now, these two holes at the top and bottom, I'm not sure if they mean anything, but I remember when I was taking this off, there's slots at the top and the bottom of this. So I'm going to line that up with those slots. Because it doesn't seem like there's like a notch. And this will go around the shaft. I'm going to put a dab of grease around here so it'll kind of go in smoothly. Wow, I'm really, really disappointed with how Kawasaki designed this. There's like 10 different ways for this seal to fail. It's like so many ways that this thing can mess up. It's ridiculous. It's so bad. Like I'm not surprised it failed at all, because there's like so many different ways that you can see this thing could just mess up. Now this is where the spring is, so I'm gonna go ahead and actually clean this a little bit. Alright, so got that on there. Alrighty, got that back on, got it nice and snug, and then went a little bit more. Just to get it nice and tight. Gonna clean up this O-ring. Gonna make sure this surface is clean around here. Gonna make sure this surface is clean around here. Make sure this O-ring is good. And then I'll slap that back on, put on the bolts, and we're getting close to being done. All right, got this nice and clean. Gonna slap her on, see how it goes. Man, this thing really sketches me out, just because there are so many. There's this seal, there's this seal, there's the one behind that, there's the O-ring behind that, then there's the mechanical seal, and then there's the seal on top of this. There are so many things that can fail. It's not even funny. And this is a terrible design by Kawasaki. I wasn't really sure until I got into this, but yeah, this is just awful. But yeah, I'm gonna put this on, snug down the bolts, top off the coolant, and go from there. But yeah, hopefully it won't leak. I didn't really have time to update, but it fixed the leak so far. Ran it for about 30 minutes and nothing yet. There's some residue from what was on there before, but it's definitely fixed. I'm gonna try and start it up again today just to make sure, and I gotta do one or two more things on this bike. I gotta clean and lube the chain, and I'll probably just wipe it down. But yeah, it worked apparently, so I'm happy that's fixed.